Hello everybody, today I'm going to show you a PlayStation Portable game, Taiko No Tatsujin, and part 2. But basically we're going to cover part 1 in this review here. This game here, if you're familiar with Taiko Drum Master, that came out on the PlayStation 2, this would be its portable version, as far as the controls went. The original Taiko Drum Master used the this Taiko Drum controller, but on the PlayStation Portable, if you're familiar with how to play it on the PlayStation 2 without the Taiko Drum, there's two hemispheres basically on the drum here, and that would be the right middle, the left middle, left outer side, and the right outer side. And in order to control it on the PlayStation Portable version, basically this would be your middle right, your middle left, and these would be your outer buttons, left and right respectively. As far as the game goes, there's a whole bunch of songs that you could drum to. As far as the songs go, they're categorized based on whether or not they're popular music, rock songs, classical music, or video game, or TV show related. Same goes for the second game, where you have a whole new list of different songs, but on both of these here, you would be able to acquire even more songs by scoring really well in order to earn points, which would open up and unlock other features. But yeah, these two games here, they are import games, but they will run on any PlayStation Portable system. As far as the language barrier goes, if you even if you don't know any Japanese, this game is pretty simple to get a hang of. As far as the game goes, let me pop in a gameplay video to show you a little bit more of what it's all about. This game here, if you're a fan of Taiko Drum Master, they came out domestically, this is a really good portable game to pick up. Thanks again for watching, guys.
お祭り広場光出す提灯の中聞こえくる太鼓の音に溢れ立つ思い鳩人さお面をつけた
First mini game.
Music,
so I guess we're out of there when the music hesitates. Gonna show certain amount of buttons that you have to press to proceed. If you notice on the bottom left, there's three dogs there, so I have three chances. Where I could actually mess up. And as you get further in this game, it actually gets harder and quicker. background noise changes when you move up to the next level. A little bit more is added to it. Easiest way to cheat on this is to do it without the music. That way it doesn't, you don't feel quite as rushed. But yeah. As you get further off to the game, it gives you less time to press the buttons that are required. Plus, they have the PSP at a vertical mode, but you would move these platforms back and forth, and they have these parts that fall down, and you're supposed to drop them down into those barrels there. And basically, those are robot Taiko drums. You're trying to build them, and depending on what parts go into them, that deciphers what type of Taiko drum robot they become. See if we can get some of these guys assembled here. Do you believe you require 5 parts to assemble these guys? Get all the parts in there, you'll see, they'll snap them off and they'll be ready to go. Oh, so many wasted parts. I'm actually doing this horizontally to try to get those beats in. Well, that one's right. Getting down. I'm playing with the corner exit. But yeah, oh, basically trying to build as many of these robots as possible within the time limit. You notice on the bottom there it says 33, that's only seconds I have left to make as many robots as possible. Oh, what should we get to go? Now what's weird is if I get that hat on off any of those guys, yeah, I built that. That brown robot there. But the parts are falling a lot faster.
Taiko No Tatsujin Portable!
As far as the layout goes, it's pretty much like the previous version. And if you get any of the other versions, the main difference would be the songs that you had. Just like my previous review, when you hit when you press the red ones, you hit the metal part of the Taiko Drum. Outer part when you come across the blue ones. When you have a larger ones like that, you get both hemispheres of the Taiko Drum simultaneously. If you notice in the middle of the Taiko Drum, there's a number that's coming out of hit consecutively. That's basically how you play the original game. And then after that, it gives you points. And if you acquire enough points, you actually level up and it'll open up stuff for you. Here we have another song. The PlayStation version, but you wouldn't need a second game, believe it or not. This game here offers game sharing, so yeah, basically all you would need is another PSP, and it'll send the information that it needs to play the game. Like the original Taiko Drum Master, this will work on any PSP system, because PSP systems are universal. Well, you really don't need to know Japanese language in order to play this game. It's a reverse game. Everything's exactly the same, so yeah. Again, thanks for watching. I'll talk to you next time.